Dear students, now we are going to discuss about the lesson The Interview, Part 2. Dear students, let us see the summary of the story, The Interview, Part 2. So in the previous part, we discussed about the opinions of the famous personalities and suggestions and methods and merits of interview. The following is a part of an interview of Italian novelist named Umberto Eco. He said that he wrote novels on Sundays. And the famous Italian novelist Umberto Eco was interviewed by Mukund Padmanabhan from the Hindu newspaper. Umberto Eco was a professor at the University of Bologna, Italy at the time. He was famous for his thoughts and semiotics interpretation of writings and the beauty of Middle Ages. Later he turned to write fiction. He wrote a variety of literature, fiction, academic texts, essays, books for children and articles for newspapers. He rose to fame in the year 1980 when his book titled The Name of the Rose became bestseller. Umberto Eco found it difficult to put into words, but began by saying that he has specific philosophical interest that he continually sought to pursue through his academic works and novels. Talking about his books for children, they all talk about nonviolence and peace, which were again based on ethics. Then he talked about his secret that he worked in empty spaces of time. He called them interstices. According to him, these empty spaces were very crucial. If you remove the empty spaces from the atoms or from the universe would be very compact, just as big as his fist. So if he was expecting someone over, that is, someone was coming to his house and the guest took the elevator from the ground floor to his flat on the third floor. As Umberto waited for the guest, that time was an interstice, and he used the interstice to write an article. So interstice means the gap or small opening. That is how he worked in such empty spaces of the time, which many people waste by sitting idle and waiting. Umberto narrated his story from his time in Italy, where a professor told that his thesis was different from others. He had told his story along with including the trials and errors that happened during his research. Others made false assumptions. He corrected them and put conclusions. This was the reason why the professor even published his thesis as a book. At the age of 22, he realized that his way of writing was the correct way, and that is why his essays were always in the narrative tone. Probably, this was also the reason why he started writing novels at the age of 50. On the contrary, his friend Roland Barthes always wanted to be a novelist along with being an essayist. Unfortunately, he died before he could do it. While for Eco, it happened by accident, but novel writing satisfied his hunger for narration. Amazed at hearing about Eco's over 40 scholarly articles, one of which was on the study of science, semiotics. Semiotics means study of science of language. He asked Mukund Padmanabhan, the reporter of Hindu newspaper, asked if he was at all bothered when people remembered him as the famous novelist. Umberto Eco replied to Mukund by accepting that yes, I didn't bother him being identified as a novelist. Umberto, on the other hand, identified himself with the academic community because he considered himself a university professor who wrote novels only on Sundays. He also attended academic conferences as opposed to pen clubs and writers' meetings. But, on the other hand, Eco accepted that he was well aware that by writing novels he was reaching wider audience, because 1 million people would not obviously be interested in stuff on semiotics. The reporter Mukund changed the topic and mentioned that The Name of the Rose was a very serious novel, and still it managed to attract a large audience. It dealt with the detective stuff and also metaphysics, theology and medieval history. He asked Umberto if he was at all surprised by his success. Umberto replied that he was not at all surprised. The only people who were surprised were journalists and publishers. This was because it was commonly believed that people liked easy reading experiences and trash, while the truth was that through his novel he reached that small percentage of the population who liked challenging reading experiences. He understood this because he himself yearned to watch shows like Miami Vice or Emergency Room after dinner, but not all day long. He asked Umberto about the possibility of success of the novel having to do something with its association with medieval history. Umberto, the writer, did not deny the possibility as he began to tell a story which he thought that he did like a Chinese wise old man. He mentioned that his American publisher expected not to sell more than 3,000 copies, as in a country like hers, no one had even seen the cathedral or studied Latin language. To their surprise, they ended up selling around 2 or 3 million copies. Umberto considered the success of his book a mystery. Had it been written 10 years earlier or later, the situation would have been different. Dear children, this is the summary of the lesson, the interview, part 2. I hope you all understand this lesson. Thank you.